rotational motion 2016 30th MCQ. A uniform disc of mass m and radius r rolls without slipping, initially along a horizontal surface and subsequently starts to climb up a ramp as shown in the figure. The disc has a linear velocity v on the horizontal surface. So if it is rolling, it will have a linear velocity and an angular velocity as well, and then angular velocity will be equal to v over r, because linear velocity is equal to r omega. Right. The moment of inertia of the disc about the axis through its center of center and normal to the plane of the disc is mr squared by 2. So we already know this half mr squared, but they have given it. What is the maximum height h to which the center of mass of the disc climb? Okay, so they have given us h. Therefore, at the maximum height, both omega and the final linear velocities will be zero. Okay, let's take this point as A, let's take this point as B. Here we have both rotational kinetic energy and linear kinetic energy, whereas here we have only gravitational potential energy if you consider this as your zero potential level. Zero potential level. Okay, so what is the equation? Linear kinetic energy at A plus rotational kinetic energy at A will be equal to gravitational potential energy at B. Right, this is half mv squared plus half I omega squared equals mgh. And then here I'll leave it as mv squared by 2 plus half into, for I you will be substituting mr squared by 2 multiplied by, for omega squared you will be substituting v squared by r squared equals mgh. Right, simple stuff. Let's get rid of the, you know, letters. We can get rid of r squared, can be cancelled out, and you can see m is common in everything, so m can be cancelled out. Right, so that will give you, on the left hand side you have v squared by 2 plus v squared by 4. 2 into 2 is 4, v squared by 4. And on the right hand side you will having gh. This is half, this is quarter. Half plus quarter is 3 quarter, so 3 v squared by 4 equals gh. Therefore, h is what we are supposed to find out, not v. H will be 3 v squared by 4 g, which is the third answer. You just should not forget, as long as you don't forget about the fact that there are two types of kinetic energies here, then you are safe. Next question is from 2019, 25th MCQ. An air mass in a cyclone moved around its eye in a spiral path as shown in the figure. Eye is the one center part. The velocity of air mass at a radial distance of 80 kilometer from the center of the eye is 150 kilometer per hour. Right? So something like this, you can just mark it like this. 150 kilometer per hour. What could be the velocity of the air mass, of the same air mass, that's important, same air mass. So let's consider this to be m, the mass as m, and when it is here it has a velocity of 150, and when it is here, what is its velocity? This is what we have to find out. It's the same air mass, m. Okay, right. So when you get questions like this, the only way you can approach this question is by considering law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. So A here, point A, point B. We'll take it like that. Now I can say angular momentum at B is equal to angular momentum at A. Now angular momentum at B, we know, we just discussed about that equation. Mass into velocity at B into RB equals the other side, mass into velocity at A into RA. Now if you're wondering how this equation came, now that if you take an object which is performing circular motion, take an object performing circular motion, the object is here and the mass is M and the radius is R, and it has a speed of V. It has a speed of V. So what is the moment of inertia of this about point 2? Moment of inertia for the for this mass, that is mr square, isn't it? Right. So angular momentum, people, angular momentum is equal to i omega, because it will have an omega, so you multiply I by omega, right? But let's substitute the values and see what's going to happen. Now for I, let's put mr squared into, for omega, what is the equation, people? We know v is equal to r omega, which gives you omega is equal to v over r. When you substitute that here, mr squared multiplied by v over r, and that will give you m v r, mass into tangential velocity into this, and that will give you angular momentum. Okay, right. So that's what I've done here, the law of conservation of angular momentum. They have mentioned that it's the same AR mass, so m and m gets cancelled off. It's just a matter of substituting the values. Vb, we need to find that. And radius to that point is 40. No need to convert the units. Va is 150. I'm not converting it because the answer is in kilometer per hour. Into, for Ra, I will substitute 80 because this is in kilometer. This also can be in kilometers. This is in kilometer per hour. So final answer, I'm going to get it in kilometers per hour. Well, that's pretty straightforward. 40 and 80 can be simplified, na? And I'll get a 2 here. 150 into 2, people. Finally, it is 300 kilometers per hour. Please don't waste your time converting the units, because either side, same. If you substitute same units, you don't have to worry. The answer for this question is quite straightforward, and that is 4th. Next question is from year 2018 and 34th MCQ. All right. A disc freely rotates without friction at a certain angular speed about a fixed vertical axis normal to the plane of the disc and passing through its center. At time t equal 0, a spider vertically lowers itself with a negligible speed onto the rim of the rotating disc as shown in the figure and becomes rest. It's like adding a new mass is added to the corner. Variation of the magnitudes of angular momentum and the angular speed of the disc only, not the system, disc only with time t is best represented by, okay, fine. Now, first and foremost, the disc will be like this without the spider and now with the spider. That's the comparison we have to do. And let me quickly mark the axis as well. This is the axis. Now this is when this is before time is equal to t naught, right? So it will be rotating at omega 1. I'll take it as omega 1. And here, yeah, okay, it's rotating at omega 1. There is no, what do you call that, the spider. Now the spider is here in the corner. Spider is here in the corner. And now definitely the angular velocity is going to change, omega 2, right? Now both the disc and the spider, both will have same omega here. That's one important thing you need to consider. All right. So here, people, I1 is just a moment of inertia of the disc. That's all. But I2, now it's going to be for the system. That is a moment of inertia of the disc plus moment of inertia of the spider, both. Right. So when you write the equation, I2 omega 2 equals I1 omega 1. I2 is this. If not, I'll just say omega 2 over omega 1. We all know. That will be equal to I1 over I2. So when you look at these two, it's obvious that I2 is bigger than I1, correct? I2 is bigger than I1. So what is the conclusion? Omega 2s must be smaller than omega 1. Look at the ratio. Omega 1 over omega 2 is equal to I1 over I2. I2 is smaller than I2. Therefore, omega 2 should be smaller, right? Omega 2, people, it's common for both the disc and the spider because both will be rotating together, right? Fine. Now, read the question. Variation of the magnitudes of angular momentum and the angular speed of the disc only. Now, moment of inertia of the disc did not change. Moment of inertia of the disc alone, that will be half mr squared or whatever it is. Half mr squared, no? Half mr squared. Here also, moment of inertia of the disc is half mr squared. What I have written is not for the disc, it's for the system. So moment of inertia of the moment of inertia of the disc alone doesn't change. But omega has reduced. Omega has reduced. If omega reduces, what will be happening to its angular momentum? Right. I'll write something. See if you can understand. Angular momentum of disc here. What will happen? That will be moment of inertia of the disc into omega 1. And here, if you take angular momentum of the disk alone, that will be moment of inertia of the disk into omega 2. Okay, right. So I'll take this as angular momentum of the disk 1, angular momentum of the disk 2. Right. So there also you can say angular momentum of disk before spider lowered itself, that is 1, should be actually greater than angular momentum of the disk after the spider lowered itself. Why? The angular velocity reduces. So momentum reduces, omega also reduces. Both momentum and omega both are reducing for disk only. For disk only. Therefore, the correct answer should be third, isn't it? The correct answer should be third. Because it's for disk only, people. It's for disk only. Right? Omega is common for both the disk and the spider, no problem. Then angular momentum of the disk will be I doesn't change, but omega is reducing, so that will also reduce. Therefore, the answer is third for this question. It will stay constant and then both will reduce.
Next question is also from the same year, 2018, the very next question, 35th MCQ. Figure shows vertical cross sections of three uniform bodies A, B and C of identical masses. A is a solid sphere of radius R. Okay, that means the moment of inertia of this is going to be 2 by 5 mR square. Now they have told that they have identical masses. Right. C is a hollow sphere of radius R. C is a hollow sphere of radius R. So IC is going to be equal to hollow sphere 2 by 3 mR square, isn't it? Yeah. The spheres can be rotated about vertical axis passing through respective centers. B is a disk of radius R which can be rotated about an axis normal to the plane of the disk passing through its center. All figures are drawn to same scale. If KEA, KEB, KEE respectively are the rotational kinetic energies to be provided for the bodies A, B and C to attain equal angular speeds, which of the following expressions is true? Okay. Fine. For a disk, what is the moment of inertia then, people? This is a disk. Now we are looking at the disk from the side. That's why the disk looks like this. I mean, it is actually this. Instead of drawing it like this, you know how a disk, right? This, instead of drawing this, they have given you that. Okay, right. A disk, when you see it from the side, it will look flat like this. No? And IB, we all know, the equation for moment of inertia of a disk is half mR square, half mR square. Half mR square. Okay, right, fine. Now we want all of them to rotate at same angular velocity, omega. Right, now we all know rotational kinetic energy that is equal to half I omega square. Half I omega square. Now all of them have to reach the same equal angular speeds. All of them have to attain equal angular speeds. Therefore, omega squared is a constant. This is a constant for all three. Constant for all three. Now this and this, half is a number anyway. These two are constants for all three. Therefore, you can say rotational kinetic energy is proportional to I. Whoever has the higher moment of inertia will have higher rotational kinetic energy. So who has the higher moment of inertia, people? It's just a matter of comparing the fractions. Na? 2 by 5 is 0.4. 1 over 2 is 0.5. 2 by 3 is 0.67, right? So we know IC is the highest one, and then we will have IB, and then we will have IA. Okay, right. So therefore, definitely the answer should be first. ABC. Answer should be first. Because this, whoever has the highest moment of inertia should attain higher rotational kinetic energy. Next question comes from year 2016, 32. A boy sitting on a smooth turntable with a weight in his each extended hand is rotating with an angular velocity of omega naught. So I'll just draw a rough diagram. A boy is seated like this and he has extended arms. So two weights are there. He has two weights like this. Okay, right. And this is the axis, and he's rotating. And he's rotating at omega naught. And the initial angular velocity, moment of inertia is I naught, I think. When he bends his hands towards his body, the angular velocity becomes omega 1. So this is actually an experiment, people. This is actually an experiment. Now he bends his hands towards him like this. Now omega is changing to omega 1 and I 1 now. Moment of inertia, I think it should be I 1. If I naught and I 1 are the moments of inertia of rotating system when hands are extended and bent towards his body respectively, then okay. Now there are two systems, a smooth turntable, so they are we can say the resultant torque that will be zero, there's no friction to reduce the momentum. Therefore, one thing you can say, there are two situations in the system, one is this, one is this. Now one thing you can definitely say is I naught omega naught should be equal to I1 omega 1. Why? Because law of conservation of angular momentum. A smooth turntable, therefore no problem there. Okay, therefore we can eliminate first and second definitely. We can eliminate them. Okay, right. And one more thing, when you compare these two, you can see here in the initial situation the masses are away from his body or away from his axis of rotation. So I naught is definitely bigger than I1 because mass here are away from the body, right? That. And I think we did a question a little while ago as well. Now, when you say I naught over I1, on the other side, it's omega 1 over omega naught. So if I naught over I naught is bigger than I1, that means you can say omega naught should be less than omega 1. Omega naught should be less than that. That means here he'll be rotating slower. And when he brings his brings the weights closer to his body, he'll start rotating faster. That's what people do in ice skating also. Ice skating, right? When they want to rotate faster, they bring their limbs closer to their body. Therefore, they can rotate faster. Okay, fine. Then considering all these things, now this is one combination we have to look for, and this is another combination we have to look for. Which one is the correct answer, people? Looks like third two. Third is the correct answer. Okay. Next question is from 2015-35. Another question about angular momentum. A child is standing at x equal to minus r, right? You can see x is measured. This is the x-axis. So child is at the corner. Minus r of a horizontal merry-go-round of radius r in a carnival as shown in the figure. X, y is a coordinate system fixed to the merry-go-round with its y-axis along the axis of rotation. Using a driving motor, the merry-go-round is set in rotational motion with constant angular velocity omega naught about its axis on a frictionless bearing and subsequently allowed to rotate freely. Now it's rotating freely on a frictionless bearing. So when it rotates freely on a frictionless bearing, that gives us the license to apply law of conservation of angular momentum. Without the driving motor, because when the driving motor is there, what will happen? It will control omega. It will be controlling omega. But if you want to apply law of conservation of momentum, it should be rotating freely, right? Fine. Now, if the child starts to move in the x direction along the diameter of merry-go-round to the location x equal to plus r, so starting from here, child moves here. The variation of the angular velocity of the merry-go-round with the position x of the child is best represented by variation of angular velocity omega. Right. Fine. Now, I'm going to quickly consider three different situations. Right. Very quickly. One, two, three. So, I'll draw rough diagrams. And the other point is this. Right. Fine. So, initially, just like they have mentioned, the child is here in the corner. Right. And then the child will be exactly at the center. Okay. Right. And then the child will be again in the corner like this. Three different situations. And there will be different omega. Omega naught here, right? Omega naught. This will take it as a omega. And this will also be omega naught. That's something you people have to understand. Why is that? Now here, if I take this, it says I naught, the moment of inertia at this point, that will be moment of inertia of the merry-go-round plus moment of inertia of the child. I'll take the mass of the child as simple m and the radius is capital R. Then what is the moment of inertia for the child? That is mr squared. And here also, the total moment of inertia of the system is moment of inertia of the merry-go-round about the center axis plus the moment of inertia of the child. Now, moment of inertia of the child is again the same because the child is in the corner. That is going to be mr squared. So at these two instances, moment of inertia is same. That's it. You know, all the answers, look at that. At minus r and plus r, same angular velocity. Why? Because the moment of inertia is same. That's why I marked it at omega naught and omega naught. Right. But when the child is exactly at the center, now this is when x is equal to minus r. This is when x is equal to plus r. What do I mean x is equal to plus r? The position of the child. When the child is here, it's x is equal to plus r. Now what is x here? X is equal to 0. And for this system, people, what is the moment of inertia? That is just moment of inertia of the merry-go-round, because r for the child now is 0. Child is at the center. So because of the child, there will not be any moment of inertia, because moment of inertia is mr squared. From the center, child is not at a distance. So when you compare the moments of inertia, now for these two situations, guys, we can write this equation. What is it? I naught omega naught is equal to I omega. And when you do the comparison, I naught is bigger than I, because here we have to add the moment of inertia of the child as well as the merry-go-round. Here it's only the moment of inertia of the merry-go-round that makes omega naught bigger than omega. No, omega naught smaller than omega. Sorry, omega naught smaller than omega. Because of this equation, right? We've been discussing about this in the previous few questions as well, right? So therefore, how many answers are possible, guys? Definitely the last three are incorrect. Last three are incorrect. And we have the first two, because at the extremes, omega will be small. Here, omega will be small, it's omega naught. At the middle, omega will be high. Now, the question is, will it be increasing linearly or non-linear? This is a curve, this is a straight line. So, we have to figure that out. What do you think is that? It's going to be a curve, because he is not, read it carefully. Now, the child moves, if the child starts to move in the x direction along the diameter of the merry-go-round to the location x equal to r, the child is moving, but the thing is, the moment of inertia of the child depends on r squared. Imagine the child is moving at constant speed every second, but I will not increase linearly because it depends on r squared. It does not depend on r. Now if it had depended on r, then what is it? When he moves 1 meter, 2 meter, 3 meter, 4 meter, then it will also, I naught will also, would have also increased linearly. But since it depends on r square, I naught does not increase or decrease rather, decrease linearly when child moves from the circumference to the center. Okay. So if I naught doesn't change linearly, omega also, it's not going to change linearly. Therefore, the answer is second. Okay, why doesn't I change linearly? Because I depends on r squared, not r. So the answer is second.